Hello students, I am Radha Kadam and today we are going to see 8th science, 8th chapter, say, structure and function. So in this chapter we are going to learn about the cell, its structure and its function. So you are aware that things around us, they are different from one another, so they are living things as well as the non-living things. And yes, just recall that every living organism performs the specific functions. So, if some specific functions of the living organism if we consider, so yes, there is the digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system, nervous system. So, these kinds of systems are there, and you are aware that all these systems when work together, the living organism will be alive. If you go in detail, so just take one digestive system. So, in the digestive system, parts are or the different organs come together and the organ system that digestive system is working. So in the digestive system, this digestive system starts with the mouth and esophagus, stomach. In the stomach also there is secretion of the pancreatic glands and the gallbladder, bile juice is secreted. Then it goes to small intestine, then large intestine, then rectum, and through anastomosis. All these small organs are working for the digestive system. So all they are made with the different kinds of cells. So in this chapter we have to learn about this basic structure of the life. You are aware that different buildings are with a different shape, color, and they are looking very nice, they are very beautiful. But if you just think that all these buildings are made with the bricks only. So as these bricks are the basic thing or the basic structure of each and every building. So like this, cell is also known as the basic structural unit of the living organism. So in detail we are going to see in this chapter. In this chapter we are going to see the discovery of the cell. Then we will just see the cell exactly, its structure, its function, number of cell, shape of cell, size of cell, and cell structure and its function. And yes, the most important part, that is the part of the cell. As well as we are going to compare the plant cell as well as the animal cell. So let's start with the first point, discovery of cell. Yeah. So in 1965, Robert Hooke observed a slice of cork from the bark of a tree under a simple magnifying glass. See, it is the time 1965. At that time, our microscopes was not developed. So accordingly, magnifying glasses are available at that time. So he observed the cork from the bark of a tree under this simple magnifying glass. And his surprise, he noticed the small boxes or the compartments in the cork slice. The boxes were separated from each other by a wall or a partition. He named each box as a cell. The cells which Hooke observed that were actually the dead cells of plants. As he took the bark means the outermost layer, and it is the set of the dead cells. Okay, in detail we are going to see in further. Now see, these cells of living organisms could be observed only after the discovery of Imbruder microscope. And very little was known about the cell for the next 150 years after the Robert Hooke's observation. And yes, today we know a lot about the cell structure and its function because of the improved microscopes having a very high magnification. Now we will see the details about the cells. So cells are the basic structural unit of a living organism. So the cell.
Cells are basic structural units of living organism. So as we see, the bricks in buildings are same, but if we consider the building, all buildings are with the different size, different shape, different color. So like this, both brick in a building and cells in the living organism are basic structural units. The buildings through build of similar bricks have different designs, shape and size. Similarly, in the living world, organisms differ from one another, but all are made up with the cell. Cells in the living organism are very complex living structures, unlike the non-living buildings or the bricks. If we consider the egg of the hen, it is represents a single cell and big enough to be seen by unaided eyes. If we consider to distinguish these cells, so some organisms are made of a single cell and some are made with many cells. So the number of cells in a tall tree and an animal like an elephant or human being are billions or trillions of cells. So these organisms which are made with the many cells are called multicellular organisms. For example, we can see the tree, elephant. Then every living organism mostly are with the multicellular cells. Now the organisms made up only one cell are called unicellular organism. For example, amoeba and paramecium. You can see in these photos of the trees, as trees are made up with the many cells, elephant is made with many cells, but amoeba and paramecium is having only one kind of cell. Now we will see shape of cells. So yes, shape of the cell when we are considering, so there are different shape of the cell. So some cells keep changing their shape, like the amoeba or the white blood cells in human being. So amoeba, it keeps on changing its shape whenever we are observing the projection of the varying length protruding out of its body. As you are aware, they are called as pseudopodia. Pseudo means false and podia means fit. So as you have learned in the 7th standard, so these projections appears and disappear as amoeba moves or as amoeba fits. You are aware that white blood cell means the WBC in human blood is another example of a single cell. Actually, it also changes its shape. But what is the difference in amoeba and white blood cell? So amoeba is a full-fledged organism which is capable of independence existence. This amoeba is a different organism, but white blood cells are single cells. They are also changing the shape, but that is the part of the blood cells, okay, or that is the part of the blood. So in that blood, white blood cells are there and they are also having a single cell. Shapes would you expect in organisms with the millions of cells? Means in this diagram you are able to see the different cells are there, blood cell, muscle cell, nerve of human being. So these all different shapes are related to their specific function. All cells, yes, they are related with the specific functions. Generally, cells are round, spherical or elongated. Some cells are long and quite pointed at both ends. So they exhibit the spindle shape, and cells sometimes are quite long, some like branch like the nerve cell or the neuron. The nerve cell, what is the function of the nerve cell? Yes, the receive and to transfer the message from brain to the each and every part of the body. So it actually helping to control and coordinate the working of different parts of the body. You are aware that which part of a cell gives its shape. So the component of the cells are enclosed in a membrane, and this membrane provides shape to the cell of plants or of animals. So the cell wall and additional covering cover the cell membrane in the plant cell, and it gives the shape and rigidity to these cells. Bacterial cells also has a cell wall. Now just see size of the cell. So cells in living organism are of different sizes, but maybe as small as millionth of meter, or a large as a few centimeter. The smallest cell is the cell of bacteria. Okay, if we consider its diameter, it's 0.1 to 0.5 micrometer. And the largest cell, if we consider, so as just we have seen, the hen's egg is one kind of single cell. So the largest cell is the egg of an ostrich. Here you are able to see the different cells with the different sides. Now just observe this onion pill.